Good morning. Today we'll start with second law of thermodynamics. The question here out is we had lost this amount of energy to the atmosphere. The question is, can we save this energy? Means, can a heat engine work without the loss of this energy? Can we save Q out? In a steam power plant, the condenser is device where large quantities of waste is rejected to rivers, lakes or the atmosphere. So this heat out is energy sink, such as the atmosphere, or this heat is given to the dumped into the lakes or rivers. Then one may ask, can we not just take the condenser out of plant and save all the waste energy? The answer to this question is unfortunately a firm no, for the simple reason that without a heat rejection process in a condenser, the cycle cannot be completed. Cyclic devices such as steam power plants cannot run continuously unless the cycle is completed. This is demonstrated next with the help of simple heat engine. Consider the simple heat engine shown in figure. So this is your simple heat engine here, having gas at 30 degrees Celsius with the load. This is, consider this heat engine that is used to lift weights. It consists of piston cylinder device with two sets of stops. The working fluid is the gas contained within the cylinder. Initially the gas temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. The piston, which is loaded with the weights, is resting on top of the load stops. Now 100 kJ of heat is transferred to the gas in the cylinder from a source at 100 degrees Celsius, causing it to expand and to raise the loaded piston until the piston reach the upper stops. So what will happen? The high temperature gas at 100 degrees Celsius will transfer 100 kJ of heat to gas. Due to this 100 kJ of heat transfer to the gas temperature will become 90 degrees, and because at 90 degrees Celsius gas volume will increase, so it will push the load. So load is lifted by this much amount. The work done on load during this expansion process is equal to increase in potential energy, say 15 kJ. So 15 kJ of amount of work is done by gas on the piston to raise its level from here to here. The work done on load during this expansion process is equal to increase in potential energy, say 15 kJ. Even under idle conditions, weightless piston, no friction, no heat losses, and quasi-equilibrium expansion, the amount of heat supplied to the gas is greater than the work done, since part of the heat supplied is used to raise the temperature of the gas. Now let us try to answer this question. Is it possible to transfer 85 kJ of excess heat at 90 degree back to the reservoir at 100 degree for later use? Means, now this 90 degree gas heat, after the removal of load, can you transfer this 90 degree Celsius, you can say heat at 90 degree Celsius, to heat reservoir back to the reservoir at 100 degree Celsius? Is this possible? The answer to this question is again no, for very simple reason that heat is always transferred from a high temperature medium to a low temperature one, and never the other way around. Therefore, we cannot cool this gas from 90 degree to 30 degree Celsius by transferring heat to reservoir at 100 degree Celsius. Instead, we have to bring the system into contact with the low temperature reservoir, say at 20 degree Celsius, so that the gas can return to its initial state by rejecting its 85 kJ of excess energy as heat to this reservoir. This energy cannot be recycled and it is properly called waste energy. So you can see here, the gas at 30 degree Celsius, if you have to convert this 90 degree gas again to low temperature, so you have to reject this heat to reservoir at low temperature, means 20 degree Celsius, because heat always flows from high temperature to low temperature. So it can lose this heat of 85 kJ at reservoir at 20 degree Celsius. This energy cannot be recycled and it is properly called waste energy. We conclude from this discussion that every heat engine must waste some energy by transferring it to low temperature reservoir in order to complete the cycle. Even under idealized conditions, the requirement that a heat engine exchange heat with at least two reservoirs for continuous operation forms the basis for the Kelvin-Planck expression of the second law of thermodynamics, discussed later in this section. The second law of thermodynamics, Carnot-Mac statement, we have demonstrated earlier with reference to heat engine shown. Even under ideal conditions, a heat engine must reject some heat to a low temperature reservoir in order to complete the cycle. That is, no heat engine can convert all the heat it receives to useful work. This limitation on thermal efficiency of heat engine forms the basis for the Carnot-Mac statement of the second law of thermodynamics, which is, it is impossible for any device that operates on a cycle to receive heat from a single reservoir and produce a net amount of work. So it is impossible that heat 100 kilowatt is coming into the engine and we can convert it to work. So this kind of engine is impossible. So that is, a heat engine must exchange heat with its a low temperature sink as well as a high temperature source to keep on recuperating. The Carnot-Mac statement can be expressed as, no heat engine can have a thermal efficiency of 100%. As for a power plant to operate, the working fluid must exchange heat with the environment as well as the furnace. Refrigerators and heat pumps, these are devices to remove heat to cool down the space. Heat pumps are used to raise the temperature of a space. In cold weather, we use heat pumps, while in warm weather, to cool down the space, we use refrigerators. We all know from experience that heat is transferred in a direction of decreasing temperature, that is, from high temperature mediums to low temperature ones. This heat transfer process occurs in nature without requiring any device. The reverse process, however, cannot occur by itself. The transfer of heat from a low temperature medium to a high temperature one requires special devices called refrigerators. Refrigerators, like heat engines, are cyclic devices. The working fluid used in refrigeration cycle is called refrigerant. The most frequently used refrigerator cycle is the vapor compression refrigeration cycle, which involves four main components: a compressor, a condenser, an expansion valve, and an evaporator. So this is the basic components of the refrigeration system. Compressor, which will take work and it will raise the pressure of the gas. When you raise the pressure, temperature of the gas will increase. Condenser, the function of this condenser is to reject heat to the surrounding medium such as kitchen air. Then expansion valve, it will allow the gas to expand. During expansion, temperature of the gas will decrease, pressure will decrease. Then this refrigerant will go to the evaporator. Evaporator will absorb QL amount of heat from the refrigerator space. So the refrigerant enters the compressor as a vapor. So at the compression rate, refrigerant is in vapor form and is compressed to the condenser pressure. It leaves the compressor at a relatively high temperature and cools down and condenses as it flows through the coils of the condenser by rejecting heat to the surrounding medium. It then enters a capillary tube where its pressure and temperature drop drastically due to the throttling effect. The low temperature refrigerant then enters the evaporator, where it evaporates by absorbing heat from the refrigerant space. The cycle is completed as the refrigerant leaves the evaporator and re-enters the compressor. In household refrigerator, the freezer compartment where heat is absorbed by the refrigerant serves as evaporator, and coils usually behind the refrigerator where heat is dissipated to the kitchen serve as condenser. At the back side of refrigerator, you had seen those small coils. Those are called condenser. While the where ice is formed, that is called evaporator. A refrigerator is shown. So you can see here, this is a heat QL which we have to remove heat from the cold space. And one thing is to be noted, to reject heat to the environment means temperature TL, we have to raise the temperature of this vapor at TH, means after compression the temperature of vapor should be TH. So then only can heat can be transferred from higher temperature to lower temperature, because heat always flows from high temperature to low temperature. It means after compression the temperature of vapor should be sufficiently above the environment temperature. Higher is the TH, more is the faster is heat transfer to the environment. So this is the overall refrigerator shown in this diagram. Now next is your coefficient of performance. In case of heat engine, we measure thermal efficiency and overall engine efficiency or mechanical efficiency. In case of refrigerator and heat pumps, we measure coefficient of performance. The efficiency of refinery is expressed in terms of coefficient of performance divided by COP. The objective of refinery is to remove heat QL from the refinery space. To accomplish this objective, it requires a work input Win. The COP of refinery can be expressed as desired output, which is QL, divided by required input, which is W net. So COP is QL, that is heat removed from refrigerator space, divided by work net supplied to the compressor. So COP relation becomes, as we can replace work with the QH minus QL. Notice that the COP can be greater than unity, that is the amount of heat removed from the refrigerator space can be greater than the amount of work input. This is in contrast to the thermal efficiency, which can never be greater than 1. In fact, one reason for expressing the efficiency of a refrigerator by another term, the COP of performance, is the desire to avoid the oddity of having efficiencies greater than unity. So these two terms are different, coefficient of performance and efficiency, they are different from each other. Next is your heat pump. The objective of heat pump is to supply heat into warmer space. So you can see here, this is a cold environment, say outside. From environment, heat will be carried by heat pump and then it will transfer to the space which is already at high temperature. Means in case of winter, heat pump will carry heat from outside low temperature air and it will transfer heat to the room which is at 25 degrees Celsius to the room. Heat pumps, another device that transfer heat from a low temperature medium to high temperature one is heat pump. Refrigerators and heat pump operate on same cycle but different their objectives. The objective of refrigerator is to maintain the refrigerator space at a low temperature by removing heat from it. Discharging this heat to a high temperature medium is merely a necessary part of the operation, not the purpose. The objective of heat pump, however, is to maintain a heated space at a high temperature. This is accomplished by absorbing heat from a low temperature source, such as well, water or cold outside air in winter, and supplying this heat to high temperature medium such as house. So you can see here, this is warm indoor at 20 degrees Celsius. This is cold outdoor at 4 degrees Celsius. So 5 kilojoule of heat is taken by this evaporator. Then work transferred to this compressor at 2 kilojoule and total is your 7 kilojoule. 7 kilojoule heat is transferred to this warm indoor at 20 degrees Celsius. So COP in this case is the desired output by required input. Desired output is 7 kilojoule. Input is your compressor work. So it is QH. You can say QH by W net. Now W net is equal to QH minus QL. So COP of heat pump is equal to this value. If you check this, it is 1 larger than COP of refrigerator. If you compare with this relation, this one, if you add 1 to into COP of refrigerator, you will get refrigeration COP of the coefficient of performance of the heat pump. So heat pump are more efficient, or you can see their performance is more compared as to the your refrigerator. Air conditioners are basically refrigerators whose refrigerator space is a room or a building instead of food compartment. A window air conditioning unit cools a room by absorbing heat from the room and discharging it to the outside. The same air conditioning unit can be used as a heat pump in winter by installing it backward, as shown in figure 6.23. When installed backward, an air conditioner functions as a heat pump. In this mode, the unit absorbs heat from the cold outside and delivers it to the room. Air conditioning system that are equipped with proper controls and a reversing valve operate as an air conditioner in summer and heat pump in winter. The performance of refrigerators and air conditioners in a United States is often expressed in terms of energy efficiency rating (EER), which is the amount of heat removed from the cooled space, in British BTU for 1 watt hour of electricity consumed. Considering 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3412 BTU and thus 1 watt hour is equal to 3.412 BTU. A unit that removes 1 kilowatt of heat from a cooled space for each kilowatt of electricity consumed, COP is 1, will have an EER for 3.412. Means if coefficient of performance is 1, then EER is equal to, as 1 watt hour and BTU are related, so it is 3.412. Therefore, the relation between EER and COP is So EER is equal to 3.41 to COP. Most air condition have a EER between 8 and 12, means COP 2.3. A high efficiency heat pump manufactured by Trane company using a reciprocating variable speed compressor is reported to have a COP of 3.3. So variable speed compressor means that this compressor can maintain at variable speed for the maximum efficiency. In air conditioning mode, for example, they operate at higher speeds on hot days and at lower speeds on cooler days, enhancing both efficiency and comfort. The efficiency of compartments, you can say, which are used for frozen foods is 1.2 to 1.5 and 1 to 1.2 for ice cream units because of their larger size and larger, you can say, pipes and higher larger size of the, so due to pressure drop and you can see heat loss from those compartments, their coefficient of performance is less as compared to coefficient of performance of your air conditioner. Also, the operating temperature is also different. For air conditioner, the operating temperature is room temperature, which is your 25 to 16 degrees Celsius. But for these, the temperature is very low. They have to produce very low temperature, so their performance decreases. The second law of thermodynamics, Clausius statement. There are two classes statements of second law. Kelvin-Planck statement, which is for heat engines. Clausius statement is moreover related to the refrigerator and heat pumps. It is impossible to construct a device that operates in a cycle and produces no effect other than the transfer of heat from a lower temperature body to higher temperature body. So you can see in this figure, from cold space heat is removed and same is heat is transferred to the warm environment without any work. So it is not possible. We have to affect the environment to transfer the heat from low temperature to the higher temperature. The factor on the environment is in terms of work. We have to take work from the surrounding, from the environment, which is in the form of compressor winding. We have to supply some electrical energy to the compressor winding to rotate it. It is common knowledge that heat does not, of its own violation, transfer from a cold medium to warmer one. Heat can't flow because heat can't flow from low temperature to high temperature itself. The Clausius statement does not imply that a cyclic device that transfers heat from a cold medium to a warmer one is impossible to construct. In fact, this is precisely what a common household refrigerator does. It simply states that a refrigerator cannot operate unless its compressor is driven by external power source such as an electric motor. This way, the net effect on surrounding involves the consumption of some energy in the form of work. In addition to the transfer of heat from a colder body to warmer one, that is, it leaves a trace in the environment surroundings. Therefore, a household refrigerator is in complete compliance with the Clausius statement of second law. Both Kelvin-Planck and Clausius statement of second law are negative statements, means they can't be proved. They are taken from the simple observation.